Dave Palumbo with another RX Muscle rant brought to you by Redcon One. All right, today's topic is ketogenic diets and how to get into ketosis and what is ketosis. You know, a lot of these, ideals about the ketogenic diet that I've been talking about for 25 years, sometimes they take for granted and people don't understand it. I get a lot of questions on a regular basis via email, via texting, private messaging, and people just don't understand it. So let me explain to you exactly what ketosis is and what my ketogenic diet is all about. All the term ketosis means is that your brain, okay, has stopped using glucose, sugar, carbs, as a fuel source, and has switched to using fats, also known as ketone bodies, as a fuel source. Now, when the brain does this, okay, when it makes this switch, okay, it no longer relies on blood sugar for its energy, and it's dipping into wherever the fat happens to be. If you're eating it, if it's grabbing it from stored body fat, okay, the brain has really an unlimited supply of fuel at this point. And that's why you feel good on a ketogenic diet, because your brain is you're not dependent on, is my blood sugar high, is it low, do I have enough? Your moods are stable because you always have a constant supply of fuel to the brain. And I think I've talked about this in the past, that is probably the most important aspect of the diet and to people sticking to the diet and getting success on it, not cheating, because moods are stable, blood sugar is stable, you don't get irritable, your brain feels good. And when you feel good, you're more likely to stick to a plan and a regimen. Having said that, now the trick is, how do we get our brain to switch its metabolism from carbohydrates to burning fat as fuel? That's the most important component of the whole equation, because if that doesn't happen, you could eat a very low-carb diet but not be in ketosis, and then you're not on a ketogenic diet. You're not getting the benefits of the brain feeling good, because the brain is still searching for glucose. That's why you can't have a bowl of oatmeal in the morning every day and not eat carbs the rest of the day and think you're in ketosis. You're not. You're just on a low-carb diet. You're not in a ketogenic diet. So people are looking and searching for ways to get your body into ketosis as fast as possible. Now, if you don't do anything, okay, and you just stop eating carbs, basically, and you eat protein and fat, it'll take 72 hours or 3 days to get your brain to switch into ketosis. Basically, what your brain does is it starts using all the stored glycogen stores in your muscles as fuel. As those glycogen stores are liberated into the bloodstream and turned into glucose, your brain is using it. When those run out, which usually takes, everyone it's different, it depends on how much stored glucose you have, then your brain starts looking for fuel, it doesn't have any. And at first it might convert some amino acids into glucose, which is happening all the time in the liver anyway, a process known as gluconeogenesis, and it might use some of that, and then eventually it's just gonna realize it doesn't have enough fuel. The brain uses a tremendous amount of glucose, way more than you would use by going to the gym and doing a weight training session, by the way. So eventually it realizes, I'm not getting any more glucose. I better switch my metabolism. I better start using fat as a fuel source. And that's when it makes that switch. It'll feel like someone turned a light switch on in your brain. You'll go from feeling really like goofy a little bit to feeling good, because now your brain has got unlimited amounts of energy. And that's what we want. People have tried to manipulate this process by saying, hey, if you take insulin, that's going to get you in ketosis faster, or you take metformin. Metformin is a drug that sensitizes your cells to insulin better, so you produce less insulin output, you absorb your carbohydrates better into the muscle cells, that'll get you in ketosis faster. But the truth is, all these crazy schemes don't do anything. They don't speed the process up, because by giving someone low blood sugar, by taking insulin, okay, that's not going to get your brain to use glucose faster. I mean, to use fats faster as a fuel source. It'll just serve to have your body release cortisol, which is a counter-regulatory hormone that raises blood glucose by turning amino acids into glucose, the process we talked about earlier, gluconeogenesis, which can occur in the liver and in the kidneys. Or it can cause your body to release, your pancreas to release another hormone known as glucagon. Glucagon takes the stored glycogen out of the muscles and liberates it as glucose. So by dropping your blood sugar using drugs like insulin or metformin, okay, all you're going to do is cause these counter-regulatory hormones to be released. And when cortisol is released, you can break down muscle tissue, because that's a lot of times these amino acids come from skeletal muscle. So we don't want that. We don't want the body in a catabolic state. Okay, that's not switching your body into ketosis faster. The reason your brain takes 3 days is because it's programmed into your body to be that way. It's like if you are addicted to opiates, okay, like Percocets, and you take them on a regular basis, then all of a sudden you stop taking them, okay, your brain is going to be jonesing for them. It wants it. It's addicted to that. It needs more, just like the brain is addicted to sugar. And it's going to take 72 hours, the exact same amount of time it takes to get into ketosis, it takes to get off the physical addiction to opiates. So your brain is really addicted to sugar, to carbohydrates, and for it to get off of that and decide, okay, I can use something else, it's going to take 72 hours. There's nothing you can do to speed that reaction up. You can do all the exercising you want at the gym. You could eat 0, 0, 0, 0 on the carbs. You can take insulin and plummet your blood. You can walk around blood sugar at 40 if you want. That's not going to get you into ketosis any faster. And if anything, it's going to probably just make you cheat on the diet because you're going to drop your blood sugar. You're going to be super hungry, and then you're going to wind up eating carbs. So these ridiculous, you know, processes, these ridiculous, you know, this ridiculous amount of information that's being put out there is just silly. And I always tell you guys, you know that this is one of my favorite sayings, don't do kooky stuff. There's a reason why I've established these rules, and I've been doing it for 30 years, because this is what works. You stop your starchy carbohydrate intake, you eat a high protein, moderate fat diet, 5 meals for women, 6 meals for men. You know, the amounts of protein and fat dependent on, you know, how much you weigh and how much muscle you have, and just wait. And in 3 days, you'll be in ketosis. You know what people tell me? How do I know? What can I do? Should I do keto sticks and pee on these things and see if... Don't do anything. If you're not eating starchy carbs, you're in ketosis. That's the bottom line. You'll know if you're in it, and you'll know if you're not in it. Because if you're not in it, you're going to feel like crap. If you're in it, you're going to feel good. Okay? If you're not eating starchy carbs, but you're not in, you feel like you're not in ketosis because your brain is just not functioning, you might be getting calories from places you don't even know, carbs, that is. You might be eating, you know, barbecue sauces or sugar-free ketchups or all, and I've done rants on this before. You might be getting carbs in sneaky places, chewing 20 pieces of sugar-free gum a day. That still has some carbs in it. So you could be sabotaging your own ability to get into ketosis. That's probably more likely what the case is. If you follow my plan, you have to be in ketosis after 3 days, 3 to 4 days. A lot of times people will get in there faster because they don't have a lot of stored glycogen. If you're carbed up to the max, you know, then it might take a little longer to deplete all those carbohydrates out. But once you do, and you're in ketosis, you'll know it, I promise you. So don't do kooky things. Don't take insulin. Another big thing. Can I take insulin when I'm on a ketogenic diet? Well, why would you want to? You're not eating carbohydrates. Insulin puts carbohydrates into the muscle cells. Okay, if you're eating virtually no carbs, your body's natural, you know, insulin-producing cells can handle whatever does come in. Now, one thing I do get asked a lot is, you know, Dave, you recommend a cheat meal once a week, obviously a carb-enriched cheat meal. How, you know, once I do that cheat meal, how long does it take for me to get back in ketosis? The way you're talking now, you would think it was 3 days, Dave. And the truth, the answer is, when you're in a strong state of ketosis and you have one carb meal, not the whole day, one meal, it will take approximately 12 hours to get you back in ketosis. If you were to eat 2 or 3 meals, you'd probably have to spend another 3 days getting back to ketosis. So it seems like your body allows you to have one slip up and it'll kind of go back to ketosis. Usually if I tell people, have your cheat meal on the last meal of the day. So if you have a nightly cheat meal, you go to bed after that, a few hours after that, you wake up in the morning, you'll probably still feel a little groggy in your brain, like you're not in ketosis. A lot of guys will go to the gym, or girls will go to the gym, they'll do cardio or do their weights. And by the time they get back, they're usually back in ketosis. Once they deplete out all that glycogen, you know, or a lot of that extra glucose in the bloodstream, their bodies seem to go right back into ketosis. And so it's a simple plan. You know, that, I'm not really going into details of the diet. I'm going into the mechanics of what make up the diet and why it works. Once again, it's not the fact that you're in ketosis that's making you burn fat better, because a low-carb diet will burn fat just as well. The reason why you're benefiting from being in a ketogenic state is because your brain feels better. And when you don't get moody, and you don't get mood swings, and your blood sugar is stable because your brain is using fats as a fuel source, not carbs, you're way more likely to succeed on the diet. And that's really what dictates success or failure, sticking to the plan. All right, I hope you guys like this this little rant I had. If you do, make sure you hit like, subscribe, turn your notifications on, and all that doohickeys. For now, I'm Dave Palumbo with another RedCon 1 RX Muscle Rant.